Let us continue the session now. And before going to find out the median of all the three types of data, I want to clarify one thing. That is, if the given data is not continuous, means how can we convert that into continuous? It is very simple. That is, we have to subtract 0.5 from the lower limit and add 0.5 to the upper limit. For example, if the data is 11 to 13, next 14 to 16. So likewise is there, means that is not a continuous. So subtract 0.5 from your lower limit. That is, first lower limit 11, so it will become 10.5. So it will become 10.5 to 13.5, and the next interval 13.5 to 16.5, it will continue like this. So after that, it will become a continuous data. Then you can proceed by the usual way, right? So before going to solve any questions in continuous data, check whether that is continuous or not. Once again repeat, how can you convert the trace into continuous? Means subtract 0.5 from your lower limit and add 0.5 to your upper limit. That's all. Now let us see the examples for median. So look at the question. So find the median of the following data. So some data are given here. So this kind of data is nothing but raw data. So how can you find out the median for the raw data? Means three stages are available. So first step is nothing but first arrange it into ascending or descending order. Then second step, count the number of terms. Then third step, if the number of terms is odd number, then the exact middle only one term will be available. That is your median. If the number of terms is even, then in your middle two terms will be available. Then find out the average of the two terms. How can you find out the average? Add the two numbers and divide it by two. So that is your median. So look at the solution. So I just arranged the given number into ascending order, and if you count, the number of terms is 7. 7 is odd number, therefore exactly the number 9 lies in the middle of the data. Therefore the median is nothing but 9, right? The next one, find the median of the following data. Look at the data. It is in the form of frequency distribution. That is second type. So second type, a formula is available, right, for finding median. So look at the example. So for frequency distribution and the continuous distribution, we have to create a table, tabular column. In both of the cases, that is in second type and third type, only three columns will be available in median. But remember that in mean, that number of columns should be according to the formula. It not a 3, not 4, like that. Okay, but in median, definitely the tabular column will contain only 3 columns. So first 2 are the data and the last one is cumulative frequency. So how can you find out the cumulative frequency? Means write the first frequency as it is, and for the second one, add the second half frequency and first half cumulative frequency. So like this. So 2 plus 4, 6. And then third half frequency, second half cumulative frequency. That is 3 plus 6, 9. Then 5 plus 9, 14. And 8 plus 14, 22. And 6 plus 22, 28. So likewise, we have to add in the cross way. Right? Next, we have to put the total of F. That is sigma F. So sigma F is nothing but 28. Why I found this one? Means in formula, the median is just greater value of N by 2. That is a formula for finding median in second data, that is frequency distribution. So that I found the value of n by 2. So n value 28 and divided by 2, the value is 14. So now we are going to find out the number in cumulative frequency just greater of 14, not exact 14, right? But in cumulative frequency 14, the number will be available here, but don't take that one. Okay, so the number should be just greater of your n by 2 value. So just greater of 14 is nothing but in the cumulative frequency 22. 28 also the greater value of, that is greater of 14 only. But we have to take the nearer value, right? So 22. So the corresponding value in X is nothing but your median, right? Suppose your n by 2 value 15, means we are selecting the value just greater of 15, not 15, right? Then the particular value in X correspond to that value is nothing but your median. So here 14 is n by 2, Therefore, here we can choose the number just greater of 14. So just greater of 14 is 22. The corresponding value in the x is nothing but 50. So 50 is your median. So that is a procedure for finding median for the second type of data. Look at the next question. Find the median of the following data. So the data is nothing but continuous data, right? Third type. So here we are going to use different formula. And already I said, before going to apply or proceed, check whether it is a continuous or not. So listen here, 0 to 10, again start from 10 onwards. So 10 to 20, again 20 to 30, and 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. So it is a continuous one only. Suppose it is not continuous, means you have to subtract 0.5 from your lower limit and add 0.5 to your upper limit. That's all. So this is the given frequency. Right. Now we are going to see the solution in the solution. So here 14 is the next term. So now we are going to find a median for the given data. So given data is nothing but the third type, that is continuous data. And look at the class interval, they are in continuous. If they are not continuous, means we have to convert them into continuous data. Right? So frequency is already given. So what is the formula for median in third time, that is in continuous data? L plus n by 2 minus cf divided by f into h. So that is the formula, right? So first we are going to create a table. So class interval, frequency, always in median, that is in frequency distribution and continuous data, in the table only three columns will come. That is the first two column, the data, and then the last two columns are nothing but cumulative frequency. So class interval 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. And frequency 5, 2, 3, 4, 8. Next we are going to fill up cumulative frequency. So how can you fill up cumulative frequency? Means write the first value as it is and then add these two and write it here. So 5 plus 2, 7, and here 3 plus 7, 10, and 4 plus 10, 14, and 14 plus 8, 22. And if you check the total of frequency, that will be also 22. So the last value of your cumulative frequency always equal to the total of the cumulative, the total of the frequency. Right? So next, we are going to substitute the formula. So in the formula, L value, N by 2, C, F, F, H, everything is there. How can you find out them? So before find out them, it is enough, that is, it is necessary to find out the median class. That is median class. So how can you find out median class? So median class is nothing but first we are going to find out n by 2 value. So n by 2 equal to, so n is the total frequency. So 22 by 2. So equal to 11. So that is the value of n by 2. Next, in the cumulative frequency, we are going to choose the value next of 11. That is just greater of 11. So just greater of 11 is nothing but 14 only. So the 22 also greater of 11 only. But here in median, we are going to find out the next of. So here 14 is the next of 11. So that the corresponding class interval to 14 is nothing but 30 to 40. So this value is nothing but your median class. So that is your median class. So you know that this is lower limit, this is upper limit. We already know that this lower limit is known as L value. And next N by 2. So N by 2 we already found, it is 11. Next CF is a cumulative frequency. So how can we find out the value of cumulative frequency? Means, so look at the median class. So just preceding value in the cumulative frequency of median class is nothing but CF. So this is a median class. So in cumulative frequency, just preceding value. So just preceding value means 10. So this is nothing but your CF. So CF 10. And H is nothing but length of class interval. That is 0 to 10, 10 to 20. So length is 10. Next frequency, F value. So F value is nothing but the corresponding frequency. The corresponding frequency of the median class is nothing but 4. So now we found all the values.
Now we are going to substitute in the formula directly. So median equal to, so L value 13 plus N by 2 value 11 minus CF value 10 and F value 4 into H value 10. So simplify this now. So 30 plus, so 11 minus 10, 1. 1 by 4 into 10. So equal to 30 plus, so multiply 10 by 4. So equal to 30 plus 10 by 4. So 2 4s are 8. Remainder 2, 5 4s are 20. So equal to 32.5. So that is the value of the median. So that is the procedure.
Okay, students. I think you will understand this video. Just go through the video at least twice, then only you can understand. And if you have any doubt, just inform me, just ask me, I'll clarify your doubt. Thank you.